maize is the staple food crop, and South Africa is one of the driest countries in the world. We experience very frequent droughts. The drought in this country affects both smallholder farmers and large-scale commercial farmers.
Libito la gake na Isaiah Malisela Sitsita. Le momotse wa mokaba tulong ya mokopane. The climate mo ya feta fetoa. Se ke sele mo ile motlo motlo wa morao kwa go tloa 1964 ke thoma o lema mo. Ke hore pula e thomile o fukotsega, thomile o fukotsana ntulo ye. Ya fisha yale yani hanchi re thoma go dia bo January mabela re beria yo tsika bo ka ka bo December le bontu a thoma uswa.
And when drought occurs in Africa, you have a lot of impact on the livelihood of people because there's no food crop, and obviously many people go hungry except they have to rely on food aid.
And therefore, it's important that we develop drought-tolerant maize varieties to ensure food security.
So I guess you know, the guy Fenya, you are fella Marao, Rare by ARC, Mulimishuarna, Etamo, Arnutisha by ARC, Yarisech, Yawema.
The Water Efficient Maize for Africa Wema project started in 2008. To develop drought-tolerant maize varieties for smallholder farmers in sub-Saharan Africa. It's in 5 countries: Kenya, South Africa, Mozambique, Tanzania, and Uganda. The variety that was launched, which is the WE3127, it was also launched together with another variety, WE3128. These are the first two conventional WEMA varieties that we released in South Africa. Essentially, they are conventional drought-tolerant hybrids.
Lina laga ke marapedi molema ki dirate moyaka ke lemo Broxby. Ntla e ya selo se go tendlo go lomi era mile thata. Thata mo go tlisang botlhoko mo e leng goreng rona re le balemi ka se sebaka ra dira ka bojotlhe re planta ka mokgwa tshwanetse re plante ka teng ga re kgone go kry-a dikuno tse ne ntse re di kry-a pele ka ntlheng ya lumo. Go a tla ba department-e gape mo go nna ke setlha se se fetileng seno se re mo go sone se 2014-15. Banko pa go rra we ne re na le di medikio wa WEMA o ne re kopa gore o tle gore plantele one e tle e re mo tsamonyana ko re bona gore a ke ka o kgona go emelana le maemo a loapi a re tshelang mo go one ka se sebaka.
The WEMA seed, it has done well throughout this drought that we had, and it has been outstanding as it has produced more than the other lands that are actually planted maize on them. And so far, yes, I could say yes, I would be able to pick up 2 tons out of it, whilst the others they only up to 1.5 tons per hectare.
We are actually marketing WEMA varieties under the trade name Drought Tego.
Drought Tego simply means maize crop that is shielded from drought. Tego is a Latin word which means shield. So we are saying that if under normal circumstances when there is drought, your crop will fail, with this Drought Tego crop, you're going to get some yield, at least 30% yield, more than the yield you would have gotten if you were not growing the Drought Tego maize plant.
most of the farms around that planted maize. Their maize, it may look nice on the outside, but when you open it, there is nothing. There is no grain at all. The maize is so dry. Some farmers even harvested it far earlier before the harvesting time because there was nothing. It was only the stalks.
Nna ke magauta mogumi ke dula tlhale for farm ke na le lemo tse 39 ke mme wa bana ba bararo polase ya ka e maluta phofung Freestata re sebetsa mona ka temo re lema poone re na le hectare tse 80 tsa poone le tse 24 tsa dinawa re sebetsa le ka dikgomo re a rekisa gore re kgone go iphedisa. Poone ena ya oema ke bona e le ntle haholo. Ha re bapisa tlhakoreng la komello e ntle haholo e hlola komello. Ha ke bone e na le bothata gobane tse ena e nngwe e ke ne ke sebetsa ka yona e batla e sentlenyana go feta ena e ntle haholo. Jwale sepheo sa ka ka poone ena ke thabetse haholo gobane ke tlo kgona gore ke fepe lelapa laka ke kgone gore ke ise lelwaleng ke lo sila ke etse phofetlang ka tlong.
Ke bone e le peo e ntle gagolo e nka ka e recommendang to most of the farmers ba batlang gore ba produce poone for home consumption le gape for di-cooperatives gore ba ka ke ba kgothaletsa gore ba feme di-cooperative ba jale mofuta ona wa poone ba kgone go e nka ba isa lelwaleng for mailing ba kgone go iketsetsa phofu then ba tlo kgona go fedisa bofuma bonana le tlala bakeng sa bana ba bone.
We found that most of the farmers are leaving their fields because of mainly drought and poor yield. They were putting more money into the soil and not getting anything out of the soil.
Yale ya raura ka rape u yone de re fa ke ba ERC ya wema. Pe u ya re shishi di tlhoka re bolela ka yona ka re iphidishe malapa rena. Pula yana. Pula yene re no fela ntshi re buna pe u ya wema ye itleng ka le ba ERC e le ge ba itswa ko agriculture.
We are encouraging farmers to use best management practices. Use the right plant density, apply the right fertilizer, plant at the right time. We give them pamphlets to use on growing of the crop so that they will apply the best management practices for the product. Now, if their yield is increasing, of course, the demand for the seed will also increase.
Again, so hurry.
The sustainability measure we have is that of educating the farmers, educating the seed company, training the seed companies on seed production, encouraging farmers to use best management practices so that they have higher yield, that we create more demand for the seed.
Drought-tego varieties are being produced and marketed by seed companies that are licensed to do that. And at the moment in South Africa, we've got Gemat Seeds, Capstone Seeds, and Seedco.
Gemat Seeds has been licensed to sell Drought Tego. And because we got it royalty free, it means the farmers will be able to get it at a reasonable price.
O fapana le ngwa o feta ngwa o feta re bile le lipuno e le kana ma masaka le kana 70 ya le ngwa o a bona ala le manyi mo re ka feta mo 110 o ya pili ba le ka re bona puno ya rena ke botse ngwa o phala ya ngwa o feta le tulo e re ya bile ka ona sithatha sila ke se se hulu broader than that a lot of last year.
We also, even after the project, we can look back one day and say, yes, we have made a difference in the life of our farmers in Africa.
My hope is that we will have farmers that are commercial, irrespective of the size of farm. And therefore, we will have farmers that are producing sufficient to sell and therefore be food self-sufficient, as well as have improved income and improved livelihoods.